Welcome back, folks. Dow's down 26. NASDAQ is up 4. S&P's are off 3. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Mark Kantzler. Mark, folks, is a sophomore at Seton Hall University in New Jersey. He happens to also be in Florida. I happen to know him from hanging out right here.
Perfect.
I figure we get... Be good to check in with the 20-year-olds and see what's going on in the universities.
Sounds great. Let's do it.
Mark, welcome to TFNN.
Good morning. Good morning. It's awesome to finally be on.
That's a beautiful thing. So here, first off, I was looking at the paper this morning. It said it was like 70 degrees in Boston yesterday. Was it beautiful in New Jersey also?
Yeah, it was. It's been sunny, so I can't complain with that. All of a sudden, it kind of turned windy today and a little brutal. You know how it goes.
As we know, the sun is beautiful.
It's been a lot better.
You gotta love it. So let me ask you something, right? So you're a sophomore at Seton. It's at Seton Hall, right? What is the thinking at your school right now in general as to like where are people going to go? What are they looking for jobs? I mean, I know you're still kind of young to really understand, not understand, but as to exactly what you're going to do.
Sure.
But just overall, kind of where is the thinking?
Yeah, I think with the majority of people I run into, you know, this commonality of thinking, such a change from, say, like our parents, right? Mm-hmm. I want this job and I'm going to do it for 40 years.
Yeah.
And now all of a sudden it's like, okay, well, I've not met anyone that has a desire to graduate at 22 and by 25 be married with a kid, right?
Yeah.
Or,
right.
You know,
change,
I want to be around the country. So I think it's really this, all of a sudden, I am in this age of entrepreneurship and science, and you can take these structures of things that have been for a long time, right? And now these things that are brand new, how do we redefine, kind of recreate, or merge them together, and either use that in your kind of typical career path, medicine,
yes,
or law, or this, you know, let's have a financial news network and also run real estate.
Sure.
And, hey, and tie these things together. So it's kind of like, just there's so much content out there about, all right, save money, take this master class on how to make your sleep better, you know?
Yeah.
And so that really just puts you, the most people I've met, wow, okay, where's, you know, not only this coming of age and all, but like, where's my heart lie and my desires relative to just the inundation of information from, you know, presidential race to NFL to, you know, a new album. So it's really just, I think, a unique point as to, wow, here's this career, but not like, maybe I get my degree and I go to graduate school, I get the job right after, but what does it mean for this long term, and where do I want to live, or do I want to travel?
Are people worried about that? The reason I'm asking is that this is pretty cool what you're saying, because it seems that they're not worried about having a long-term job. Because, I mean, what is happening in my cycle, I'm old enough to remember when it turned, and people were really mad when it turned.
Sure.
Meaning that, you know, let's say you're going to school, you could normally sometimes get out of school and have a job, whether it's IBM or something else, 20, 30 years, have a huge retirement. And that has changed dramatically.
Yeah.
So my question is, that's not even on the table with you folks at this point, right? Because the turn has been so long, right? Would that be correct?
Yeah, I would say so, at least in my experience, or most of it, most interactions.
Which is pretty cool, because then you have clearer thinking.
Concern. Right?
I guess.
Maybe.
Clarity that you can't get a job that has a pension. I mean, I guess.
Yeah.
But. Yeah. No, I've not sat down and, you know, been like, oh, are you worried about what's happening at 45 or 55 or 60 plus?
Yeah.
I don't really on a daily basis go, oh, man.
Maybe part of it
is going to lead me.
Jump in, Mark. The way I think about it, there's a lot more mobility, freedom, the mobile age of being able to do things from a variety of, you know, you used to have to be in a factory at a workstation doing your job because it was a lot of manual or whatever it was, you know, whether you were just writing on paper, you had to be there. Nowadays, you have a laptop, you can be anywhere in the world, and you're going to have a lot of freedoms to do a lot of jobs in a lot of capacities.
And it's, that's what's the amazing thing, and kind of was thinking of in your last question, right? Yeah, you can sell homes, you can create markets for anything you want to sell information, like you're saying, yeah. And as far as the master classes and the things you can learn without sitting in the classroom, without, you know, like you're saying, sitting in the factory, learning how to put this together, and then it's going to go on that line, so on and so forth. So it's just kind of like, yeah, look at these options. Now, what's interesting is that that can be kind of turned, right? You can get complacent and be like, oh, yeah, I have all this at my fingertips. So like, oh, I'll figure it out. And figure out becomes 3 months, becomes 5 years.
Yes.
Right. And you just take a job. So I don't want to say like everyone out there is, you know, on this campus has that ambition to do that. But yeah, it's definitely not the, oh, man, I got to find this job and figure out what I'm doing. Now, in some places, people are like, yeah, I'll pay my dues, so to speak, and move on. But I personally kind of go, why? Like, I understand, I agree fully with experience and learning and mentorship. But at the same time, there's all these things that we're referencing. There's such an ability that's never been there before to try whether if you want to do 20 different things, or if you want to get really good at, you know, life coaching, and then you want to get really good at artwork, you have that ability, and now even more so in the sense of, you know, mental awareness, spiritual awareness, body awareness, and all the things that come with that, and mental health these days. It's just like, wow. You know, you're unpacking so much, which can be overwhelming.
Sure.
As well.
So, but, you know, let me ask you, what comes up in the markets quite a bit, okay, is that the amount of debt that young people are taking on. So how does that, you know, you go to basically a big university there,
sure.
Right? Now, I know you're a swimmer, but what is the conversation, you know, on campus about debt? Is there a conversation, or is that just put off?
It's interesting. I don't know if conversation is the word I'd want to use.
Okay. Yeah.
I think like you're saying, it's brought up a lot by, you know, the guys that say, why are you going to college? You know, what in the entrepreneurship age, you know, these guys that are doing very well for themselves, right? And whatever that may be. And they're like, what are you spending 60 grand on a year?
Yeah.
Now, between us and administration or them having events, not really. You know, I think it's right. It's still being run as this business, which you kind of get. But I've had a few with other, you know, got peers, and just kind of at the how ridiculous it is, right? I mean, how crazy it is to for some people to be putting everything on their name, all this money. Yeah. They got to put forth and pay back somehow. And
you don't have a
maybe
plan
not,
to pay it off, especially. Yeah.
Okay. Well, listen,
so,
man.
It's worrisome.
We'll continue this conversation, Mark. Listen, man, you have a great one, safe one, have a great weekend, and we look forward to speaking to you again.
All right, brothers.
Thank you.
Thanks, Mark.
Stay right there, folks. Tommy and I are coming right back. Dow's down 6. Nasdaq's up 13. S&P's are off 2. Come right back.